amplify our first pictures of Mr. Churchill in Canada come these additional shots from Quebec. In the public mind, this great gathering of leaders is precursory to momentous Allied moves. Mrs. Churchill and her daughter Mary avail themselves of the opportunity to do a little sightseeing. In place of a limousine, they used a one-horsepower calèche to take them on their tour. On the terrace of the Citadel are the men who have shaped future history. Upon their deliberations hang the whole course of events, not distant but immediate action. The British and Canadian chiefs of staff get down to business. Lord Louis Mountbatten is appointed Supreme Allied Commander in Southeast Asia. A new command created for conducting operations against Japan. The whole broad field of global action is covered during these war-shaping discussions. By transatlantic clipper come Mr. Eden and Mr. Brendan Bracken. The Foreign Secretary and the Minister of Information hasten to the conference to assist in the untangling of those political knots which military success in Europe has disclosed. Swift-moving events are adding to the weight of business. A disintegrating Italy, a resurgent France, a quickening in the Balkans, and Denmark in revolt. And all the world is on tiptoe for electrifying news. But riding through all this is that steady, firm Anglo-American friendship which finds renewed expression on Canadian soil. The Countess of Athlone is pictured in this group. The Earl of Athlone, the Governor General, is recognized on the left of the back row. The Prime Minister, President Roosevelt, and Mr. MacKenzie King hold secrets shortly to be revealed in terms of bold action.